Let's put the diaphragm aside for a second there. So before I kind of start talking about some of these muscles and how they connect to different symptoms, I want you to just appreciate how much muscle tissue I've had to remove so we can actually get there. So I've left the right side completely intact. I've not really removed anything there whatsoever, whereas on the left side I've removed everything in the way. So I had to remove obviously the external abdominis, abdominal oblique, the internal obliques, the rectus abdominis, the TVA, even like all these muscles that make up the abdominal wall. We're gonna remove the linea alba as well there, just so you can see it from both sides. And then here you've got the latissimus dorsi, which you can actually see. Again, this is actually quite important and interesting. And again, it's the proximity of the latissimus dorsi to the QL and the psoas. So as you can see, once the abdominals are gone, you've got that protection coming from the latissimus dorsi because it connects onto the iliac crest, which is this. And let's fade everything around the psoas major and the QL so you can see them together. And there you go. So they're actually sticking to each other, which is again very interesting. And you're gonna see in a second, well, we can actually see it visually there. So essentially, the insertion point of the psoas major, or I would probably, it's better to say the origin point, is the bodies of the lumbar vertebra there, but also the transverse processes. Okay, so these points there, so let me just kind of get rid of this. This is the psoas major. You can actually see it from the back, so this is why I selected it from this angle. So you can see how the psoas major, if I'm to fade everything around, connects into the transverse process, because these are the transverse processes here, the parts of the vertebra that stick sideways, and this is the spinous process. But this is the body on the front where you got these kind of connection points. So there's a very, very solid connection between the psoas major and the lumbar spine. And the condition that I've essentially faced with some of these clients is something called neuralgia paresthetica, which is something that some of you may have heard before. It's essentially a compression of a little bit of a relative to the femoral nerve, and that is the lateral cutaneous femoral nerve, which essentially is on the side here. We're gonna look at that in a second. But it can also have implications on the femoral nerve as well, because the symptoms that you get with the neuralgia paresthetica is the numbness and tingling on the potentially on the outside of the thigh, but even like lower down towards the center of the thigh. And it's a very dangerous condition because sometimes operation is required. So there's been multiple times where I've actually dealt with patients who've been diagnosed with this condition, and they've had the symptoms, but after releasing the psoas major, the iliacus, and essentially doing some of the femoral nerve gliding and mobilization techniques, all the symptoms have gone away and the person has been able to regain back their normal movement and strength, which is crazy because they were so close to essentially being opened up and cut up and stuff like that. So just quickly, I want to show you two nerves that are very interesting here, and this is the first one here. So that's the genitofemoral nerve, and then the second one is the ilioinguinal nerve here. So these are nerves that essentially supply some of the sensation and function of your genitals. Obviously, it's different with male and female. With males, these nerves, especially the genitofemoral, will supply the muscles giving you sensation and some of the function of the testicles, whereas with females, it's different. But nonetheless, these are nerves that supply sensation down here. And again, whenever someone gets symptoms of numbness or tingling or whatever else going on in the genitals area, we're always like, the first thing that kind of goes into my mind is called equina, which is a very serious condition. Again, tingling, potentially loss of function and stuff like that. So I'm not saying that every single condition that relates to cauda equina is going to be caused because of tightness in the psoas major, but I'm saying that we should keep an open mind and